This is The Rundown. I'm Hari Sreenivasan. On PBS stations around the country, there is a special produced by NOVA and National Geographic called Venom, Nature's Killer, and we are joined by the director, Chad Cohen. Thanks for being with us.
Thank you.
Really kind of fascinating, creepy but fascinating, when you look so closely at snakes and snails and spiders and you realize how powerful the venom is that we just don't really, I mean, you've heard these stories, but when you actually see these creatures and how powerful they are, it's startling.
Yeah, it's unbelievable. I mean, when you think about, you know, this tiny snail that lives protected just off of our beaches, Hawaii, elsewhere around the world, that, you know, it has the amount of venom in, like, this little thing to kill three men, you know, with one shoot of its harpoon. It's, yeah, it's staggering.
There's a tiny harpoon that actually goes in, and it's catching fast fish, even though it's a slow snail.
And, you know, that's exactly right. It needs to. So that's the reason for that amount of venom. You know, when you think you're this snail, you can barely move in the water, and these fish are swimming by, you need pretty much everything at your disposal that you can throw at it. So, you know, instead of, like, you know, a little bit of venom to stunt the prey, they need a lot all at once to stop it and basically essentially stop it from swimming away.
Now, you guys focused on some really interesting characters. They go out of their way to do the very things that we would avoid doing. They run around in forests looking for snakes. They move cupboards away to look for spiders.
Yeah. They call themselves toxinologists, and they are basically, you know, bent on going out to, you know, your backyards, scary basements, you know, jungles in Vietnam, to all these places to basically understand what are these chemicals, how and why did they evolve, and how might we put them to use to help ourselves.
And some of those toxins have turned into incredibly powerful drugs already.
Yeah, it's unbelievable when you think about it. The main chemical behind ACE inhibitors, you know, that saves hundreds of lives, you know, every day, mm-hmm. is derived from a snake. Integrilin, which is given to patients in a hospital, if you have a heart attack, and it's usually caused by some kind of platelet blockage, the first thing that doctors are going to do, they're going to give you a catheter, they're going to bust it with a stent, but then they're going to give you this chemical that stops platelets from forming, keeping the clot open. That chemical in a snake is basically doing the same thing.
So how do we get from a venom to a vaccine, or not a vaccine, but a cure? What's that process?
Well, it starts out in these jungles, right? It starts by figuring out what these chemicals are. There's something like 20 million toxins out in nature. We've only started studying about a few hundred of them. But from that few hundred, they've isolated something like 12, like a dozen drugs.
Wow.
That came from a relatively small number of chemicals, so which is pretty amazing.
So they're actually taking almost the DNA of the venom itself and figuring out what the proteins are doing inside.
Venoms are toxins, which are proteins.
Right.
And, you know, proteins, we have, you know, lots of them in our bodies, and they control what our cells do. They tell them to go over here or do over there or turn this on or turn that off. And essentially, a toxin is a protein gone bad, you know, for us at least.
Right.
Good for the snake maybe, but bad for us.
Right.
And so they essentially have done something evolutionarily that is to their benefit, to do something really bad to our cells.
Was it the jellyfish that can completely just destroy blood cells and turn it into just
soup? Is
that
the most insane thing? Yeah, we're saying, so Angel Yanagihara is that researcher, amazing story. She had an attack, she was a swimmer, she had this terrible attack when she was younger. She just finished her PhD program and almost died. She almost died of anaphylactic shock from these terrible jellyfish things off of Hawaii. And basically decided to devote her life to understanding what the hell it was that almost killed her. She takes her own blood, she puts it on a slide, she takes the jellyfish venom, which she basically goes hunting for all night long and extracts and adds the venom to her blood, and you can watch on the screen these blood cells just basically exploding, just popping. And the hemoglobin, which they use to carry oxygen, just kind of, you know, going out there, not being able to be helpful. So you can just watch this crazy reaction, and it's quick. It's really quick.
So what's something that you experienced in Vietnam that was left on the cutting room floor?
Our natural convulsion is to be afraid of these things. They slither and they, you know, they crawl
and they're almost neon colors and they're just sitting there.
Yeah. When you're out there, you're filming these things, you do your job, the camera's in the right place, everything's where it should be. But then that snake is on the ground and loose, and you just can't help doing that mental calculation, like, all right, it's not going to do this. But if it wanted to, it could go down around that tree, over that rock, around that, and right to me, you know. And sure enough, you know, it happens, you know, the thing gets on the ground and around the trunk, down the tree, and literally through my legs. Wow. You know, as you're filming, and you know, you take solace in the fact that they're deaf. So, you know, I wasn't moving, but I was saying things that I can't say right now as it happens.
All right, on that note, Chad Cohen, the special is called Venom, Nature's Killer.
Yeah.
It's produced by NOVA and National Geographic. Check it out on your local PBS stations. This is The Rundown. I'm Hari Sreenivasan. Stay with us.